कुछ होने में और बहुत कुछ होने में इतना सा फर्क है, एक बार सोच के छोड़ देने में और लग के कर दिखाने में, मान लेने में कि जिंदगी ऐसे ही कटेगी, और सुबह 4 बजे उठ के सोचने में कि अभी तो बस शुरुआत है, किसी मैगजीन को हाथ में लेने में और उसी मैगजीन के कवर पेज पे होने में इतना सा ही तो फर्क है, वीआईपी सीट में और उसकी पिछली सीट में इतना सा ही तो फर्क है, वो जिसका मैदान ही खुला आसमान है वही कल जमीन पर तो था, पूछोगे तो बताएगा वो पंछी, ये एक दायरे में सिमटने में और पूरी दुनिया को दायरा बनाने में बस इतना सा फर्क है, इतना कितना है, इतना है या इतना है, जो नापेगा वो जाने कि जहां धरती और आसमान मिलते हैं, नानकपुर से दूर अगर मगर शायद से दूर, वहां भी दोनों में फर्क बस इतना सा है, धरती और सातवें आसमान में फर्क बस इतना सा है। ये एक अंतर प्रेरणा है, ये हमारी आपकी हम सब की अंतर प्रेरणा है, एक कदम, एक छलांग, एक बाजी, एक गहरी सांस और एक ललकार खुली हवाओं में कि हाँ मैं बना हूं उन फिजाओं के लिए, कि हाँ मैं बना हूं उन ऊंचाइयों के लिए जो ऊंची तो बहुत है पर नामुमकिन भी नहीं, क्योंकि मुमकिन और नामुमकिन में बस इतना सा फर्क, धूप छांव में फर्क बस इतना सा। तो बस चलिए फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया के साथ ये फर्क मिटा देते हैं। फ्रेंचाइज इंडिया, 20 years of ideas.
A very good afternoon to all the friends, families, and potential business buyers. We, the entire team of Franchise India, welcome all of you to our Business Opportunity with Chai webinar series. This is a 45-minute digital representation of the business opportunity which we have got for you. It's our everyday aim, objective, and mission to provide maximum business solutions, helping all investors in getting the maximum business opportunities input, industry insights from our side, so that they take a conscious and a right decision of selecting the perfect franchise for themselves. We truly claim that no one sells more business than us, because we have helped more than 80,000 investors in getting the business solutions from our side. And we have helped international and national bodies and brands to expand their business with our 80 plus offices. It is our privilege to invite and welcome management team of Franchise India for this particular webinar. Sonia Ma'am and Gaurav sir, both are hosting this particular webinar for all our investors. The business opportunity which we have got for all of you is Mission Sports, the brand which is offering franchisee invested company operated business model. And today we have invited the team to talk about end-to-end business model, financial model of Mission Sports. They are also offering the minimum guarantee to all the investors joining them. And we welcome Mr. Vishwash as well as Lakshmi to take us through the entire presentation. Thank you so much, Vishwash, for joining in today. I also welcome and invite Sharad Babu, who is our very senior resource IFC partner from Bangalore. Thank you so much, Sharad, for joining in today. And it's our privilege to represent this particular brand. So welcome, Vishwash, over to you to talk about your brand. Vishwash, you are on mute.
So very, very good. Hello, Sonia. And hi, Sharad. So
this is Hi, sir.
Director of Mission Sports. And I just want to introduce about myself and my experience, that how I started this company and from which background I came from. Actually, I started studying from SDAT, that is Sports Development Authorities of India, from the grade 8, from 8th standard onwards. And I played for basketball and I played under 16 youth nationals and under 18 youth Junior India. And after that, I played for Indian Army team for 5 years from 96 to 2001. Then I worked with many institutions, many clubs as assistant basketball coach, and I worked with many international schools in Bangalore as a basketball coach, and I also I worked as a head operation in Cool Sports Mumbai. Then in 2012, I started incorporated the company in Bangalore, the Karnataka ROC. Then from 2012 to 2016, we were in creating the content for the curriculum for 8 different sports. So all this effort for 4 years, we are the team which we created a curriculum are all certified in AISTS, Mastering Sports Science and Technology, which is located in Lausanne, Switzerland, in the International Olympic Committee body. So after that, we were in the mid, and we served in schools and stuff. And 2012, we signed up with brand endorsement with PV Sindhu. And she's a Olympic medalist and second time, the first woman who got the second medal in Olympic. So I'm very proud to have for the mission sports as an endorsement. And B2B2C, due to this pandemic, and even we cannot wait for to give the service for the students.
So Lakshmi, I think we are losing him in between. Can we start with the presentation by the time he joins us back?
Yes, Archana, sure, we'll start with the presentation. And you can go with the slide one. So yes, coming to Mission Sports. Mission Sports is a sports education company. And we all have been hearing Mission Sports all these days. What Mission Sports actually do is, we are a sports education company who provides sports education service as a part of a curriculum to the school kids. So in India, we all know academics has been a very strong content and curriculum we have for academics. But considerably in sports, we all have taken a very back step. Means we all are treating sports only as an entertainment, but not as a serious basics. To overcome that, we Mission Sports has been associated with International Olympic Committee. And we have created an 8,000 pages of curriculum specially for sports. That 8,000 pages of curriculum we have converted into animated videos, which will help and understand the kids to learn the curriculum in an easy methodology. So coming to this curriculum have been utilized by kids from KG to 12 standard. Depends to the age category, how they learn science, maths or social or any other subjects. Like that, they are learning sports as well, which will come with basic etiquette, starting from how to hold a racket or how to hold a bat, starting from that to how to be a specialist of that game. Until that, we Mission Sports are training them. So in this particular curriculum, we have all the categories of games. Currently, we are servicing 5 different games like basketball, tennis, football, volleyball, and badminton. We are currently practicing that. So in these games, the kids are understanding each and every level and coming up to the championship level, we are treating them. And we charge only 2,500 rupees per kid for one whole year to give multiple services. That services include sports curriculum. Second would be the nutrition guidance, where we have our in-house nutritionist team. That particular nutritionist team will help the kids to understand about their own health, their own nutrition guidance on their day-to-day activities. With the help of parents, we guide them through that. Apart from that, we give them daily in-house physical activity. We have our own coaches who will be giving them the live sessions per week based on their accessibility. So this is all about the company. And Archana, can you run through the slide where we can find the returns?
Yes, So Lakshmi, we'll go slide by slide.
Yes, as of now, I have explained about the company which comes and company and service which comes with the first few slides. And if you are going to the slide of the financials, we can explain about the franchising more. Yes, we'll start from this. So coming to the franchising model, we are giving franchisee in, franchisee owned, company operated model. Why we are giving franchisee in this particular model? The reason is any other brands like food and beverage or cosmetic or automobile, coming to those brands, all those brands will be opening a store or a shop for a franchisee. But the franchisee will run the shop and will be sharing the revenue depends to the profitable margin. But here, the company used to do the service. Whatever sales the franchisee is doing, the company has to do the service. That's why we are giving the franchisee in, franchisee owned, company operated model, where you can see the refundable deposit would be 10 lakhs, which means we are giving you 175% of ROI, plus we are giving you a refund of the investment which you are doing with the monthly assured revenue. So the term period of the agreement would be 61 months. Why we have put it as 61 months instead of 60 months is we are taking an operational break for the first month because the company needs the operational period as first month. That's why we are taking it as 61 months of return. So the total revenue would be 175% over the period of 5 years. Can you move on to the next slide? Arshana, can you shift to the next slide? Yes. So this is about the termination clause. If at all the franchisee wants to get terminated from the business, they have certain clauses to get terminated. These are all the clauses. So coming from month 8 to month 19, the franchisee is eligible for the termination. Why we are giving the months from month 8 to month 19 is by the time of month 23, the franchisee would already got back their invested amount. So after 23 months, it's all of their profit. That's why we are not refunding the amount after 19 months. And starting from month 8 to month 19 depends to the return on investment, which means the monthly assured return which they have got, we are giving them the refund. Can you shift to the next slide, Achana? This is going to be the monthly assured revenue which the company promises to give to the franchisee. Why we have kept it as a minimum assured revenue is the company would target the number of licenses, but whatever goes up or goes down, the minimum assured revenue stays the same. Even if the company's performance and everything depends, the minimum assured revenue will hit the franchisee at any cost because they are investing in a FOCO model. Next slide, please, Ashna. We'll come back to the slide again. I'll explain you how this calculation has been done. Can you shift two more slides down, Ashna? Yes. So this is the minimum assured licensing target which the company is targeting. So which means 550 license is yearly target for the investment of 10 lakhs. Why we have quoted 550 as the number of license for 10 lakhs, I'll explain you. So depends to the area which the franchisee wants to take. Depends to that, we have fixed the investment amount for each and every territory. That investment amount is based on the productivity and the population, the number of students, the number of schools in that area, we have fixed the investment amount. So if a person is investing 10 lakhs, the company has already done the formulation and the basics that how much number of students would be there in the area. In such case, if a person is investing 10 lakhs, that area will cover minimum of 50,000 to 1 lakh students, out of which our target is going to be only 2,750 license for the whole 5 years to give you this return. So how we calculate the return is 550 into 2,500 per license, which we charge for. You go ahead, slide Archana. One slide ahead. Before, not after that, one slide. So 2,500 comes to you, which is 5,000,000 per year. why we have mentioned 5,04,000 only for the first year is because we are taking a break on the first month. So this 550, can you go a slide ahead again, Ashna? So that 550 has been divided equivalently to all the months, and we have given you the return of 45,833 per month as minimum assured revenue. So whatever goes higher than 550, you can track through your mobile application, which the company is going to launch in a month's time with all the new features. So in that mobile application, you can track how the license is performing. So whatever goes higher than the 550 license, again, the investor would be paid off with the excessive revenue for each and every license as 40%. So I'm coming to the franchisees part. So we are giving it in the FOCO model, which is franchisee-owned company-operated model. There, all the part the company is taking care. So if you come to the franchisee's part, what would be the franchisee's involvement in this business? So what franchisee is involving is either if a franchisee feels that I want to be a silent franchisee, in such case, we are giving it a silent franchisee where the company is taking care of everything, and you are just involving yourself as a silent investor tracking the business. So coming to an active franchising model. In an active franchising model also, all these revenue shares and the return remains the same. Apart from this, franchisee can put their involvement into the business for each and every license which the franchisee is clinching. Out of 2,500 rupees, the franchisee is going to get 60%, which is completely an optional, which is not a mandatory part in this franchisee role. And as I said, we are giving you 175%. Can you go a slide down, Ashna? We are giving you 175% of return. So 175% of 10 lakh would be 17 lakh and 50,000. Here you can see we have added your 10 lakhs also, which is a refundable amount, and we are giving you the return of 27 lakh and 50,000. So this is all about the financial parts of the company. And coming to the service part, I hope I have explained you the service parts. So going deep in the service, what Mission Sports and what is the mission of Mission Sports is? So Mission Sports obviously wishes that to create healthy future generation through sports, because sports has been a part of the life for the prior generation. Coming to the current generation, we all have been a point where we are not involving ourselves into a physically active world, especially the children. So to involve them into the physically active world, we are bringing sports education as a part of their day-to-day physical activity. Yes. So I hope I have explained you all these parts, and any Q&A session we want to follow, I'll forward it to my MD, Mr. Vishwanathan Mani. So he'll be helping you out with the Q&A sessions.
Thank you so much, Lakshmiji and Vishwanathi. And Vishwanathi, because we have, you know, had some connectivity problem when you initiated, and I'll have some questions on the business model. At the same time, I will also request all our friends who have joined in, whatever question friends you have, please use Q&A and ask these questions. And Vishwanathi, because we lost the connection initially, I would like if you can start with telling a little bit about the company Mission Sports, how it started. Currently, how many centers are we running? Which are the regions we are performing well? So a little bit about the company, if you want to tell all our listeners. Are you able to hear me, Vishwanathi? I'm not sure.
1 minute, I'm checking his line number.
Yeah, actually, your voice is breaking. I can hear you something, but your can you hear me?
Yes, yes, yes. Very much, Vishwanathi. Because we were losing you in between, I will request, before we take up any questions on the financial model, I will request if you can talk a little bit about the company, how it started, your current centers, where are we running, which markets are doing well for you, so that people understand the background. Yes.
Yeah. See, actually, we believe the healthy lifestyle is important for everyone, and right now more than 60% of the students are not in ideal weight. So actually, Mission Sports is not committed to create any medalist or champions, because first of all, we just want to educate them how to play, you know, what is the need of physical activity. So everything they just have to, you know, understand from the grassroots level, from the, you know, age of fourth standard itself, we have a curriculum. So suddenly, you know, out of this 130 crores of population, we cannot create, you know, medalists and champions suddenly when they reach of 9th standard and 10th standard and don't know anything about the rules and etiquette and technique of the game. So see how actually the PT classes is performing in schools. Everyone knows, everybody knows that. Kids will go to the class, PT, you know, to the ground, and they will play whatever the game they want. The PT masters will blow the whistle and then they'll call everyone to go to there for the next period. So I just want to compare with sports education and also with the normal academic education.
We can't hear you, Vishwanathji. Lakshmi, if you can hear us, I will request if you can take up some questions on the business model. I think we've lost him.
Yes, I'll just go ahead with the Q&A or questions, whatever it is getting.
Yes, would you want to talk a little bit, you know, Abhi, how many centers do we have? Which are the locations that we are currently running? And also a little bit on how long we've been running these centers.
I'll tell you. So the company started in the year 2012. So starting the company in the 2012, it is all about the curriculum preparation, because each and every content and curriculum takes a long time for the company to develop it. So we have been taking 4 to 5 years of time to develop this curriculum. After that, we have been going and pitching the model with the schools. We do directly did the B2B model. In this B2B model, what we do is we do cleanse the schools. We give them direct service to the schools. And from the year 2017, we have been giving franchisee. And overall, we have been given 75 plus franchisee across whole South India. Currently, we are targeting to move pan India. And for that first step, we have started to move to Maharashtra, and we are closing few of our franchisees in Maharashtra in the upcoming weeks. Apart from that, if you see, the company has revamped this model to B2C model. What is this B2C model? Is instead of giving this license to every individual schools, the company has started to give the license to every individual student, where we charge 2,500 rupees per kid and we give them all these services. Why we have moved to this B2C particular model is, in this B2C model, what happens is each and every individual gets their individual attention. In this individual attention, we are treating the kids on the right track of their path, where all their nutrition guidance has been treated, all their sports guidance has been treated. That's why we have shifted ourselves to this B2C model, particularly from B2B model. And also, if you see, 2,500 rupees per kid spending for a parent has been no matter of time, because parents are ready to spend more on sports and sports education nowadays. That's the reason we are shifting ourselves to this B2C model particularly. And we already have 75 plus franchisees across whole South India. As I said, we are targeting to move pan India, starting from Assam, Chhattisgarh, Goa, Gujarat, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Jharkhand, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Odisha, Punjab, Rajasthan, and Union Territories, and also Uttar Pradesh and West Bengal, we are currently targeting for. And as this step, we have started to move to Maharashtra. And Maharashtra, we have done an event, and from that, we are closing few deals in the upcoming weeks.
So when we talk about these centers, are these are there also physical centers that we run, or these are all virtual classes that we do?
So talking about the physical centers, yes. Physically we train the kids over the school, which is where the kid is already studying. We go train them in the school, and also we tie up with academies, like sports academies, basketball, cricket, tennis, football, all the academies we tie up. In that particular academy, we train the kids. And this particular Mission Sports model is also there, where we train the trainers. We have our certified trainers with that. Our certified trainers will be training the trainers of the school and also about the academies.
So when I talk about, so what you're saying is there is no infrastructure which is needed, but you have your trainers in every city which also would go to respective schools and train the children. Is that right?
Exactly, Ashna. Okay. Exactly.
All right. Now, and if I have to understand, we've talked about an investment of 10 odd lakhs and the agreement period is about 5 years and 1 month. What is the breakup of this investment of 10 lakhs? Where is this investment deployed?
So this particular investment of the franchisee, why we are taking this? So Mission Sports expands the business in each and every territory and each and every area with the help of franchisee's investment. Consider a franchisee is taking a part of Thane or Mumbai city or Mumbai suburb and anywhere. In that particular area, company has to deploy its employees first. So deploying the employees would be the first step. Second, on the operational cost. Operation in the sense, appointing a brand ambassador, common expenditures of the company like mass media marketing, brand ambassador marketing, all these would be a common investments. So apart from that, their particular territories investment like generating the leads and expanding the business with the help of promotional activities to cleanse the sales, activities which the company do to promote the company in that particular area. This investment is utilized to expand the business in that particular territory. Out of what we are expanding, whatever the revenue which we get back, we are sharing 40% with the franchisee.
So what we are saying is, you know, the entire investment, initial investment of 10 lakhs is something which the company will use to market and promote the brand in that particular region. And also will use that money for taking care of all the operating expenses at their end, so, and which includes maybe the team that they would deploy in these cities. Now, Lakshmi, if I have to understand, you know, going further, because a franchisee would be a passive investor in this business and the entire operations are run by you. What kind of visibility are we giving to our partner to understand, I would say, you know, the business that we have reached in that city? For example, if you talk about maybe a place like Bombay also, you know, so what visibility would a franchise partner have on the people which are deployed, one, and second, would he be also updated on the progress which his region is doing, second, and third is also a visibility on the performance of the business? So these are my three questions on, if you can answer.
Got it, Ashna. So talking about the visibility, so the franchisee is first given up with a mobile application which the company is having. Through that mobile application, the franchisee will be tracking how much business is performing in that particular territory or area. With that, the franchisee will come to know either the company is going on the minimum assured slab or the excessive revenue. That is case number one. Apart from that, the franchisee is visible to understand how the business, the company sends a monthly report of how much areas, how the area is performing, how much licenses has been clinched, all those emails has been sent to the franchisee. Apart from that, we do conduct yearly events with the franchisees and the brand ambassador, where in that event, the franchisee will come to understand about the whole progress of the company throughout the year, which we have already and clearly conducted in Chennai, Coimbatore, all these areas. Due to COVID, currently we haven't conducted the events. After the COVID, we are planning to conduct an event again. In that, all the franchisees will be there, our brand ambassadors will be there. All these interactions will happen for the franchisee to make the transparency of the business.
That's helpful. And there's very important questions which I also see coming from one of our partners, Mr. Indrajit, you know, because typically any partner who's investing in the business is a pure passive investor. The question is, you know, what kind of security are we offering to the franchise partner against the investment he has done, you know? So where I think just to maybe expand that further, the minimum guarantee that we're talking about, does it come to him in terms of some PDCs which are given to him, some kind of bank guarantees? How is that assurance given to a partner is the question.
So coming to the assurance part, Archana, we are giving them the agreement which is a legal binding agreement. In that, we mentioned them, this is going to be your month-on-month revenue and about the excessive share, everything we are mentioning them in the agreement. Apart from the agreement, we also included one part, which is an add-on part for the franchisee in the agreement, which is the franchisee will be getting back their invested amount along with 10% of rate of interest, if at all, on the worst case scenario, if anything happens. That would be a security for them that their invested amount with 10% of rate of interest is going to hit them. That is also mentioned in the legal binding agreement itself.
Okay, so there's only an agreement there is no PDC or bank guarantees given by the company. And I see a lot of other questions also coming in. And, you know, we also have Sharadji, who's a partner. He's also leading the project and business from franchise expansion point of view for Mission Sports. And I welcome Sharadji. He's a very experienced partner of Franchise India. He has been working with us for the last many years and handling the territory for us in south of India. And Sharadji, can I request if you would like to take some questions from the audience or any questions that you feel can be in the interest of the audience who are all out here. Over to you.
Yeah. Thank you, ma'am. Thanks for the introduction, ma'am, Sonia, ma'am. And basically, if you look at it, this particular brand, if you look at Mission Sports, it is a pandemic-proof brand. It will be a pandemic-proof investment for all our investors because Mission Sports equally had moved on from B2B to B2C segment also, where the individual subscriptions tapping the individual parents who are very keen and who understand the overall holistic development of a child in terms of having the sports as a daily way of life, it will strengthen their muscles, it will give them that enough exercise and also the strength training and the mental stamina which is required for the child to face the outside world and also to be fit for having a better mind also. And overall development, it is a complete 360 degree child development. So the Mission Sports, like Vishwanathan sir had told and Rajalakshmi ma'am had told, basically it is to develop and build the sporting culture, entire sporting culture in India, which is like a way of sporting will be a way of life. So for that, they have come up with, I also see somebody asking, what is the security do you provide for? So Rajalakshmi ji, do you have any answer for this? Any particular security, in terms of the security?
So security part, I already explained that. Yeah, Sharad. So coming to the security part, I have already explained about what would be the basic security the company would be providing on the behalf. And we also, I would like to explain one thing that this is also a franchising like any other FOFO model franchising, where the franchisee will be taking a store or a shop and the customer, whatever the revenue or the operation that has happened from the franchisee's end, it has been taken care by the company in this case. The only difference between the other franchising and our franchising would be company is taking care of all your business activities, sales and the service to the customers. That's why the company is promising you for the minimum assured revenue. So it is all about the business. So if you balance between FOFO and FOCO, it is almost the same. Coming to the security part, in the sense, business is provided with the security of minimum assured revenue and we are also providing the security clause for your investment as well.
Thank you. So there were some of our investors, one of our investors is asking, who are your celebrity brand ambassadors?
Currently, we are having PV Sindhu as our brand ambassador. And in future, we are expanding and we are preparing to onboard brand ambassador for each and every game we have. Like for cricket, we are planning for a person. And for tennis, we are planning for a person. We are trying to expand our brand ambassadors' endorsements with many other celebrity brand ambassadors in the upcoming months.
Yeah, Mr. Abu Tahir is asking, hopefully this is a successful idea in current sports conditions in India. You have any comments further on that? Any you want to give any further insights on how successful this concept, the business model of yours is going to be, or what is any specific, vision you have, or to summarize, what kind of prospects do you see for your brand in terms of sports education in India?
So coming to the future of this particular business, so India is booming towards the technological aspects. So if you see 5 years back, this technology and the smart class has been on a backstep. But now if you see everything, whatever we go, everything is online. You want to learn a coding class, everything is online. If you want to learn any academics, it is online. But coming particularly to a sport, why do not we have a proper curriculum for a sport? So sports, how it is taught is kids go play something, they come back. But it is not taught like any other academic or subject from the basic. Even sport has a basic where if you want to play a basketball, you have to have these abilities to play a basketball. So coming to our business in the future, so future is now about always about education, medicine, all these are taking a very big steps in India in the future businesses. So in such case, sports education is something which all the other countries have where India is not having it. So now, and the interest of the parents towards the sports has been virally increased. People are ready to spend in thousands to send their kid to an academy and teach them. But it is not same for all the parents over all the age category, because people are different from the financial aspects. In such case, the model which we are giving with the amount which we are going to spend, the licensing amount which is 2500 plus taxes, is affordable by any category of the parents, where sports is common for all. Everyone should afford sport to be physically fit in their lifestyle.
Yeah, so Mr. Mohan, you are talking about, you just joined this meeting, not a problem. We have a recorded session of this, and that link will be shared by our team to you after the webinar. And Mr. Jain, there is no FOFO model available. This is a FOCO model available, which is a franchisee-owned and company-operated model, where as an investor, you will be a silent partner, like how Rajalakshmi ma'am and Vishwanathan sir had briefed before about this. So in this model, where you will be getting the fixed returns, and also there are two variable percentages which are there. Would you like to just quickly throw, I know you briefed it again, but quickly throw light on the guaranteed return and also the the variable model, that is the 40% and 60% also, Rajalakshmi, if you don't mind.
Sure, Sharad. So as a person has asked about the FOFO model, so FOFO model is also attached with our FOFO model. That is one of the biggest advantage about our brand, which I would like to tell. So if a person wants to invest and go on a FOFO model where he should also be actively participating, that is also available with us. This FOCO model gives you 175% of return for 5 years, which is 35% per annum, which will also be added with your invested amount, will also get back to you. In this case, whatever the company is doing out of 2,500 rupees per license, whatever the company is selling, we are going to give you 40% of each and every sale which the company is doing apart from the minimum assured revenue. So coming to a FOFO involvement, in this case, franchisee can also be an active partner where he can also go to the sales. The company will give you a sales training. For whatever sale the franchisee is doing from his end, he'll be getting 60% out of 2,500 rupees. Where here FOFO and FOCO are involved together. Even if a franchisee wants to participate actively in the FOFO model, this minimum assured revenue and the company's participation will also be there, where that is an add-on advantage for the franchisee, where he gets his minimum assured revenue on a slab, whereas he is also doing his business and getting his excessive revenue.
Yeah. So Mr. Abu Tahir, yes, this is a very successful model, and they have already 75 franchises pan-India. I'm just adding on to what we answered before. So this model is where the live simulated software and the live players' actions will be recorded. in terms of curriculum, based on the curriculum, and those animated videos, I mean, just like Byju's, you can call it as a combination of offline and online. As far as online is concerned, you can take an example of Byju's, but it is a little more advanced than Byju's, because here live players, in terms of sporting I'm talking about, live players' actions are recorded for coaching purpose. That's how it is. So this is the future of sporting, where a blend of both online and offline education, depending on the end user or the kids' requirements are concerned. Mission Sports is had developed it quite flexible model to deliver both offline and online. Thank you. Yeah. Yes, sure. Mr. Vishal, you had expressed your interest for Nagpur location. Definitely, yes. Our Franchise India team will get in touch with you after the webinar. Yes, franchise. Mr. Mohan is asking about whether franchise depends on locality or cover all states. Can you throw some light on this, Rashmiji?
So, can you come back with the question, Sharath?
Yeah. So, the investor is asking whether franchise depends on locality or it is going to cover all states. That means he is asking whether any one specific locality or a franchise can be taken across all states, he's asking. That might be his.
So the franchisee, we are giving it an exclusive franchisee model where we have available models and sold out model, where if you get in touch with our team will share you the available and sold out model. From the available model, you can pick whichever area you want to do the business in. Why we are giving based on the area is based on the area, your excessive revenue would also be shared with you. That's the reason we are having it based on the territory, which is it can be a taluk, it can be a district, or it can be a state, depends to the investment which you are making.
I'd like to add on more, probably what Mr. Mohan Kumar is asking is, irrespective of the current locality where he is staying, since it is a FOCO model, and where the investor is a silent partner. So can he take anywhere else in the country? Is that probably that also might be the, I'm just assuming on behalf of the investor. So is there any possibility like that? Suppose let's say an investor is from Bangalore, but he wants to invest somewhere in Hyderabad or somewhere. Can he or she invest?
Yes, he can or she can. Reason is this is a FOCO model. The company is going to do the business for you. So anywhere, wherever you feel the potential is more, where it is a metro or where it is a tier one, wherever you feel that this area's potential is more and this area's investment, if we make the excessive revenue be more, the franchisee can invest. The reason is it's a FOCO model. The company is going to do everything for you. So it is possible.
Yeah, there's one more question. I just want to understand. Mr. Jagdish Lokhande wants to understand about an elaborate, is there any elaborate rollout plan? And if it is there, what kind of investors you are looking for?
So we do not look for any particular kind of investors or something. It is all about the interest of the investor to do this franchising business. So we do not specificate or specialize any particular investor module that this should be our investor. No. If you are an investor who wants to invest particular invested amount and if you are ready for the investment, we are ready to onboard you.
Okay. So also, I think, so you are open for franchises Pan India, if I'm not wrong.
Exactly.
And Mr. Sanjay Diwan also wants to know, can we switch between FOCO and FOFO? But I think there is no FOFO. But so as far as in the future, in the near future, are you also, you and your management, are you also looking at having a FOFO model also?
Yeah, Sharath. As I explained to you, we have FOFO also now itself. If the franchisee is participating actively, that is a FOFO model. So here it is both of FOFO and FOCO. If a franchisee investor wants to participate actively, even now we have that model.
Can you also, one of the investors is asking if, whether it will be also great if you can play a video about how, you know, things work with simulations and real life trainings for students. Is there any short video maybe 10 seconds or you know something you can play right now, which will give them some insights about how the training is imparted for the students. Some kind of any particular sport or something you can take and play a 10 seconds video or something like that, maybe 10, 20 seconds.
Yeah, sure.
So, yes, I think for Nagpur it is open, right? One of our investors is asking for Nagpur.
Yeah, it is open for Nagpur. So for that particular investor, if he is giving us the details, we can also give him a demo link with which he can go into and find about how the module is working. All those we can even give it for him.
Sure, our Franchise India team will get in touch and from there we can take it up.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, sure. This was helpful session, and if you have any questions that you want to ask, and I think we've tried to cover a lot of information that you had asked for, and I see a lot of you asking for the presentation to be shared, and we would be able to share that with you. And equally, I think what is also important, because you need to understand how the business operates, anyone who wants to have any references of schools the company has been associated with in these locations, they would share the same with you. And we have a discovery day that we're holding in this week, the coming week. And Ashna, can I request to put on the date in the chat box, and we can announce to our investors on the event. And friends, we'll arrange a one-to-one call. And if you're local, you can meet the brand founder and the leadership team, Lakshmiji and Vishwanarchi, at their offices. And the date is 6th of October, which is next week. So this is a day that we're doing a discovery day. Whatever you want to know about the brand, the people behind, the business they have been doing, their success stories, any references that you need, the company would be able to share all that with you. We'll block any time between 30 to 45 minutes for you on that day. And I will now request Vishwanarchi and Lakshmiji, before we close, maybe a last word from you, any message that you want to give to all the investors, audience which is present here.
Okay. So, and thank you everyone for being on this live and getting all our company details, showing interest about your Q&A. And I would like to thank Sonia for being a part of this, and you have been a real support to make us explore more. And we wish to have a same kind of relationship with you for all the upcoming years as well. Sonia, thanks for bringing the brand all over this. And for all this period, you have been a great support for the brand. Thank you so much for that.
Thank you so much, friends, for being with us. And Sanjayji, we let you know, you want to know how soon you can come on board. We will have our teams at Franchise India reach out to you immediately after the webinar. And especially for all our investors who have asked the questions, I understand their interest is at peak. So we'll take up all our investors on a priority who have reached out to us, and we'll start blocking slots with all of you for 6th. For reasons you're not available and you would want to speak maybe between today or tomorrow, we'll also take that as maybe a priority with the brand, and look for a suitable time for a call or a meeting. Thank you so much once again for being with us. And can I request Ashna to take it up from here, please?
Sure. So thank you so much, Vishwa. Thank you so much, Lakshmi. Thanks, Sharad, for joining in today. Thank you so much, Sonia, ma'am, for sparing time, taking all the queries. All the dear friends, do reach out to us in case you want to block a time with us to have one-to-one interaction with Lakshmi and Vishwa on Discovery Day, which is happening on 6th of October. Please reach out to us at our business hotline number, which is 97176-83838. Also share your suggestion, feedback to us at our different social handles, because that will help us in improving our process. Also connect with Gaurav sir and Sonia ma'am at their LinkedIn ID to get more information, more industry insights and expert advice. And tomorrow, under our business opportunity over chai webinar series, 12 p.m. prime time webinar, we are inviting you to join us for Nukkad Dhaba.
It's a restaurant from Chandigarh, and they are providing the pure vegetarian food to all the consumers. So if you want to start a F&B business, join us tomorrow by doing registration. You can do registration with us by joining us at our business hotline number or go to Facebook page where we have shared the registration link. Thank you so much once again for joining in today. Have a safe day. Thank you so much.